This week on 49ers, Cal High Sports presented by U.S. Bank. Big league games from all around the Bay Area will show you De La Salle taking on San Ramon Valley. Valley Christian hosts Bellarmine and De Anza battles Salesian.
Softball includes Amador Valley and Livermore. Volleyball with Kent Belindo and Northgate. Plus the story of the Half Moon Bay High School basketball player inspired by the life of his sister. It's all next on 49ers, Cal High Sports presented by U.S. Bank.
Welcome to 49ers Cal High Sports presented by U.S. Bank. I'm Robert Bronstein.
And I'm Aubrey Tolliver. We start tonight in the West Catholic League, where four teams come into the week within two games of first place St. Francis. The Valley Christian Warriors were just one game back with Jake Hudson batting .528 with 19 hits for the Warriors.
One game behind Valley Christian is the Bellarmine Bells. The Bells have a balanced offense with Chase Knight leading the Bells with 15 hits. Bellarmine at Valley Christian on Tuesday.
Jake Vanderbrook in San Jose's Valley Christian takes on Bellarmine. Top three, Bellarmine looks to ring the bell as Rowan Kelly hits a high fly ball in the deep left field, and you can kiss that ball goodbye. A solo shot for the sophomore, 1-0 Bells. But the Warriors respond in the bottom half as Easton Kreschel drives this ball to left center field. A few hops to the fence, Tatum Marsh scores. Kreschel stops at third. He would score off a sacrifice fly to put Valley Christian up 2-1. Top four, Thomas Trombador hits a rocket the third. This ball goes off the third baseman's glove for a single. Nate Escalada scores, all tied at two apiece. Jump to the sixth, more Bells and more Trombadors. He crushes this ball to deep left center field. This ball stays in the park for a double. Two-run score, 6-4 Bellarmine, and the Bells are very happy about that. But the Warriors respond with runners in scoring position. Hunter Fujimoto hits a grounder to short, and number one is safe at first. Quinton Marsh scores, 4-3 Bellarmine. Next batter, Tatum Marsh smokes this ball to left field for a base knock. All tied at four. Nobody scored in the seventh. We're heading to extra innings. Top of the 10th, Bells have a runner on third. Rowan Kelly gets a good jump off the wild pitch, and he's safe. Bellarmine back on top, but Valley Christian responds. Same situation, same result as Keaton Norris is safe at the plate. And because it was getting dark out, the umps call it official in the 11th. No one wins, no one loses. This game ends in a tie.
Adrian Soriano here in Saratoga as prospect takes on Silver Creek. Great defense early from the Raiders as Van Smith lays out to make a terrific catch. No score after one. Prospect gets on the board in the second. Jack Austin sends one deep to left field, just inside fair territory. Matt Castillo scores. Right behind them is Ethan Horio. 2-0 Panthers after two. Meanwhile, Evan Pagano was dealing for the Panthers. Evan getting one of his 8 strikeouts on the day. Prospect extends its lead in the fifth. Kyle Paulus rips it deep to center field. That falls in just shy of the track as Jack Austin races around third to score. 3-0 Prospect Panthers. A couple batters later, Ellis Lubians grounds one to short. The throw gets away as Paulus comes in to score. Prospect tacks out a couple more runs later in the inning to make it 5-0 Panthers after 5. Silver Creek gets one back in the 6th. Xavier Jimenez hits one to left. That's deep enough to score Van Smith. It's 5-1 Prospect. The Raiders looking to rally in the 7th, but Kevin Joseph Ryden gets the strikeout to end the game as Prospect wins it 7-1 to go to 2-1 in the Blossom Valley Santa Teresa Division.
Ivan Garcia here in Pinole as the Pinole Valley Spartans host St. Mary's Panthers. Bottom first and a runner on second. Vanessa Castaneda bunts. An off throw to first leads to a collision, and Dominique Dels Reyes trots home as the Spartans strike first. 1-0. Runner now on third. A wild pitch causes the runner to go. Julia Runyon finds the ball, holds on, and tags the runner to save a run. Great awareness from Runyon. Bottom second. 5 straight walks for Pinole Valley as the Spartans take a 3-0 lead. One out now. Runners in scoring position. And De Los Reyes hits a double into left field, clearing the bases. Melania Rosales and Eliana Lerma are brought home. Spartans up 5. Still in the second, and after some more walks and wild pitches, the Spartans are extending the lead. Runners in scoring positions again. Brianna Sweetheart drops the ball into left field. Castaneda and Jennifer Ramirez go home. Spartans up 11-0. Pinole Valley's Kehlani Tatro was dominant on the mound. A no-hitter with 8 strikeouts as the explosive offense of the Spartans and gem from Tatro lead to a 16-0 win over the Panthers.
We'll jump to Moraga for some volleyball. Northgate meeting Campolindo at center court. Courtney Tate with the highlights. Set one, Campolindo ahead. Northgate fights to get it over, but Andrew Pack sends it right back home to score 11-6 Cougars. Campolindo with the chance to take the first set. Pack gets it up to Nikolai Bell. Nikolai crushes it to the hardwood, and Campo takes that one 25-22. Second set, Northgate looking to tie it up, and Max Grigoriev gets the job done with a big-time block. We're tied at 7. Cougars start to pull away later in the second. And Andrew Pax finds Patrick Bulk. Patrick with the monster slam, and the Cougars take the second set 24-19. Third set, Northgate with a strong start. Will Bedorf bumps it up to Luke Steinert. Luke with a nice shot to extend the lead. It's 11-7 Broncos. The Broncos keep the momentum later in the third. Here's Reese Jordahl with an incredible block to extend the lead. Northgate sends this to a fourth set. Fourth set, this one going point for point. Andrew Pax sends it up to Nikolai Bell, and Nikolai slams it home to extend the lead to two. Finally, Campolindo ready to close it out. Here's Andrew to Josh Ewart. Josh with a beautiful shot to the hardwood. Campolindo pulls out the 3-1 win behind a 16-kill performance by Nikolai Bell.
Each week, we present the Players of the Week in a wrap produced by the great folks at the Rikus Center.
The players chosen from their performances in last week's games. Here are the Gary Rikus Players of the Week.
Yeah, Rikus Center. 49ers Cal High. Your Gary Rikus Players of the Week. Let's get it rolling with a freshman sensation. From Granada High, a slugging first baseman, Delaney Almua. This lady will wow recruiters. Against Foothill, nobody could outdo her. Smacking a double and a three-run blast. Driving in 5 runs, watching she run fast. Around the bases for the Matadors in comeback fashion. Got the win in this anticipated conference action. You should see him on the mound, the way he throws is scary. It's Woodside senior Ben Giovanetti. Sending batters from the box, quickly back to the dugout. As he tossed a complete game, one-hit shutout. Striking out dying, shutting down San Mateo, putting holes in his swings like a cinnamon bagel. Got the win for the Wildcats, he never lost focus. He added 2 hits and 2 runs as a bonus. That's right, Rikus Center, Bennett Roth, 49ers Cal High, Sports Report. Your Gary Rikus Players of the Week.
Sanford Healthcare brings us great advice for athletes every week.
Here's Dr. Michael Freehill with this week's tip.
Hydration is one of the most important nutritional concerns for an athlete. Around 60% of body weight is water. With athletics or working out, fluid is lost through the skin with sweat and the lungs while breathing. When lost fluid is not replaced at regular intervals during athletics, it can lead to dehydration. A dehydrated athlete has a decreased volume of blood circulating through the body. The best way to prevent dehydration is to consume plenty of fluids before, during, and after a workout or competition. Have a bottle of fluid available when working out and drink as often as desired, ideally every 15 to 20 minutes. Also, do not wait to drink until you are thirsty.
Coming up, our first SunPower Electric game as De Anza takes on Silesia.
And Santa Teresa meets league rival Willow Glen. This is 49ers Cal High Sports presented by U.S. Bank. Rikus Center's Community Service Program in Menlo Park provides a unique opportunity for you to gain valuable leadership and life skills while working in a diverse and exciting environment. Whether you're looking to complete school service hours, gain relevant experience for a job or college, or immerse yourself in all the Rikus Center has to offer, our Community Service Program gives you the opportunity to engage your community, make meaningful human connections, and learn new skills in athletic fitness, creative arts, and nature awareness. Got goals? Come to the Rikus Center.
Cody!
Hi.
Hi! How are you?
I'm good. I'm crocheting.
I see that.
It started off as a hobby, kind of snowballed from there. And Alex, I don't want to stop.
Well, I don't see why you should have to. Let's set you up with a side gig savings goal on the U.S. Bank mobile app. This way you can turn it into your main hustle before you know it.
You're my hero, Alex.
What are you working on now?
Pool cover.
That's fun.
Oh, I made my wife a bathing suit.
Oh, did Linda like it?
She did not.
Oh.
You should see what I made for Max. Max, look at him. He loves it.
The confidence to make your dream a reality. U.S. Bank. We'll get there together.
For nearly half a century, Devcon Construction has helped build, perform, design, and sustain the dreams of Bay Area schools. Devcon Construction's buildings and fields are the foundation for many of our finest schools. The exceptional quality of our finished product is a huge reason we are ranked as the largest builder in Silicon Valley and why Devcon gets 95% of its business from repeat customers for future projects. Devcon Construction will continue to build our communities from schools to stadiums. Nearly half a century of quality service and a history of success.
Warriors, established 1946, celebrating 75 years of Warriors basketball. Get your tickets now at warriors.com.
49ers Cal High Sports is brought to you by these fine companies who care about high school sports. By U.S. Bank, life keeps moving. We're here for every step. U.S. Bank member FDIC. By Stanford Healthcare, number one in Northern California in orthopedics. By SunPower, proud partner of the 49ers. And by Stevens Creek Chevrolet, find new roads.
Welcome back to Levi's Stadium, where the Salesian Pride is rocking the Rock Division so far this season with a 6-0 league record.
The Pride meeting De Anza this week. The Dons come into the game with a 4-0 league record. It's a game for sole possession of first place, and it's our NCS SunPower Electric game. Jake Vanderbrook was there.
We have a huge NCS SunPower Electric game for you in Richmond as De Anza takes on Salesian. Both teams have a lot of talent. For De Anza, Tawan Everett is on our radar. The senior is hitting 545. Look for him to be effective in the batter's box. And for Salesian, the Olsen duo is something to watch out for. Both Devin and Chris Olsen are hitting over 500 and are very dangerous on the bases. To the highlights, De Anza threatening early. Here's a high fly ball to the left field, and this ball finds the grass. Tawan Everett and Nico Taylor scores. Two zip Dons. David Fernandez looking good on the mound early. He gets the batter looking with the off speed to end the second inning. More defense in the third. Dons looking to steal a bag, but Jake Rogers wasn't having it as he fires a dart to get the runner out at second. And that deserves a fist bump from the umpire. But on the very next pitch, Caden Schott hits a deep shot to left center. And you can kiss that ball goodbye. A solo shot for the senior. De Anza now leads 3-0. De Anza threatening in the fourth. Terrell Ferguson hits this ball to left field for a base knock. 4-0 De Anza. We mentioned earlier, Tawan Everett's a threat at the plate. Here he lays down a gorgeous bunt for a single, one of his two hits in the ballgame. Salesian showing no quit, down 6-0. Andre Prince lifts this ball to right field for a base hit. Here comes Johnny Drake. The Pride would tack on another run in the fourth to make it 6-2. Fifth inning, take David Fernandez to Wendy's and buy him a 4-for-4 because the sophomore went 4-for-4 at the plate, including this RBI single in the fifth. In the bottom half, though, Pride down 8-2. Johnny Drake hits a grounder to second. Nico Taylor, the California baseball commit, sprints the first to record the out, but Daniel Pons scores to make it 8-3. More Dons in the seventh. Halon Lovan hits a ground ball to second. The throw the first is not in time. One run scores. Here comes RJ Gay Jr. sliding head first. De Anza rolls past Salesian, winning 11-4. Fernandez talks about the team win after the game.
Close game coming in. We were really evenly matched. So we're really lucky to just give them our all. We're just a group of guys just, you know, having fun out there. And now the confidence is really high.
In Richmond with the NCS SunPower Electric game, I'm Jake Vanderbrook, 49ers, Cal High Sports.
The Santa Teresa Saints and their Mallard mascot all ready to go at Willow Glen. The Saints on the board first in the first as Dylan Green smashes this one to straightaway center field over the fielder's head. Green races to third with a stand-up triple. He later scored on a ground out, 1-0 Saints. To the second now, Isaiah Alvarado at the plate, and he sends it high and deep to right field off the base of the fence. One run is in. Here comes Brad Tran to make it 3-0. Alvarado out at third, but that is a two-run double. Santa Teresa starter Brandon Ashley doing a fine job on the mound, not giving up a hit through the first three innings, this one of his five strikeouts in the game. Top three now, two on for Anthony Castro, who hits a can of corn to left. Dylan Green scores from third, racing around third, and heading for home is Ricky Vidal, 5-0 Saints after three. Same score in the fifth. And have a game, Dylan Green. This one hit high and deep to left, and it is gone. A solo shot for the outstanding senior. That's Dylan's fourth home run of the season. He's hitting 421 and is an outstanding catcher. Great D here by the Saints. Vidal at short, snagging the hot shot, then throwing from his backside. That's a great play. And that was a big out because the Rams get two runs in that fifth inning. Mark Bonenberger with a solid single to right. Ty Dance heading for home and safe at the plate. Saints up 7-3 in the seventh, and the Sprinklers decide to go on, which brought a big smile to Saints pitcher Riley Breton in this week's Invisalign Bright Smile Award. Saints win at 7-3 behind big games for Green and Alvarado.
Albany's Construction brings us the Dirty Work play each week. This is a play with the same type of grit and determination shown by the good folks at Albany's Construction.
This week's Dirty Work play goes to Alex Johnson from Northgate. Alex, with a runner at second, comes in and makes a tumbling great catch. Alex Johnson doing the dirty work, just like Albany's Construction. Stevens Creek Chevrolet brings us the Spirit Corner each week, celebrating top cheer and dance teams from all around the Bay Area.
This week we feature the girls from Carlmont High School.
Coming up to the very top East Bay League for Foothill and California.
But first, here's our Cupertino Electric Power Rankings for baseball.
How powerful is an Invisalign smile? So powerful, you can face anything, even these faces. Invis is a powerful thing. Invis is the clear aligner brand most trusted by doctors and more predictable. Invisalign.
Right now, my electrical bill is about $10 a month.
This is definitely one of the best investment we did in our house.
All over the country, people are taking control over their electric bills by going solar with SunPower. We offer the most efficient, durable panels on the market, so you can see a return on your investment every month.
I was paying $220 a month. Now I pay about $22 a month.
Right now, 49ers faithful get a $1,000 Visa reward card from SunPower. Go online today.
Kids these days, they're curious, creative, kind, and resilient. A generation of tolerant givers and doers, kids these days are redefining what it means to show their true colors and shine bright. At Clover the Rainbow, we're committed to powering their brilliance with nutritious, organic, American Humane Certified Dairy and teaching them the importance of eating all the colors of the rainbow. Clover the Rainbow, power your brilliance.
From the beginning, Merriwest Credit Union was created to provide a brighter financial future for you. We work hard for our members because they're our greatest strength.
Merriwest worked for me when I needed an auto loan for my first car.
When I need to make a mobile payment, Merriwest works for me.
Merriwest works for me wherever adventure takes us.
Merriwest Credit Union, let us work for you today, tomorrow, together.
Since 1974, there's been just one goal. One thing we work for. The pursuit binds us together and pushes us forward. One family with one mission. To win for this city. Vamos, San Jose.
Wow. No braces, everything's hands-free. I wasn't so lucky.
Invis is not your parents' braces. Invis is faster than braces and the clear aligner brand most trusted by doctors, Invisalign.
We are the Los Gatos Wildcats.
And you're watching
49ers
Cal High Sports,
presented by
U.S. Bank.
The East Bay League has five teams within one game of first place coming into the week. The Foothill Falcons at 4-0 feature power-hitting third baseman Jack Basir, who has five home runs and 17 RBIs this season.
Yeah, he is really good. One game behind the Falcons, the California Grizzlies have hot-hitting senior Raul Fabian, who's hitting .514 with 18 hits this season. A battle at the top of the East Bay League Friday afternoon.
Jake Vanderbrook in Pleasanton as Foothill takes on California. Bottom of the first, Jack Basir hits this ball up the middle for a base hit. Few batters later, Brendan Comerford is going to drive this ball to right for a base knock. Basir comes home to score 1-0 Foothill. Next batter, Evan Bilter gets a good jump off a wild pitch and slides head first to extend the Falcons' lead to 2. Great pitching from both teams in this one. Tyler Gebb was dealing on the bump for Foothill, finishing with 8 strikeouts, including this one, to get out of the second inning. Nick Bronzini was racking up the strikeouts as well. 11 strikeouts for the LSU commit, including this K to get out of the 5th inning. The Grizzlies show some life in the 6th. Runner on first, Brady Wetzel looks to steal second. The throw goes into the outfield. Wetzel gets up, looks to take third, and the senior is safe. A few pitches later, Aiden Camber drives this ball to left for a base knock. Wetzel comes home to score. Cal now trailing 2-1. But in the 7th, Grizzlies down to their final out. Here's a ground to the short. Brendan Comerford gets down and dirty, gets back up, fires the second for the final out. Foothill hangs on to beat Cal 2-1.
The Amador Valley Dons getting ready to hit the field, meeting Livermore. The Cowboys score first in the first, runner at second for Elizabeth Ruiz, who sends a looping liner over short, racing around third and scoring as Taylor Rapp, 1-0 Livermore. Cowboys threatening again in the third. Taylor Rodriguez had a great game for Livermore. Tayrod with a line double to the fence in left center. Taylor Rapp stops at second. It's a double for Rodriguez. Next batter is Ruiz, and she's clutch again, sending a bomb to left center. One hop to the wall. Rapp is home. Here comes the pinch runner, Kerrigan. And Coach Ruiz safe at third with a triple. The ball gets away, but Ruiz stays put. The Cowboys looking to add on, but the line shot caught by Alina Helms at second. She throws to first to make sure, but that's a nice catch. But the Cowboys do add on in the 5th. Rodriguez hits it high and deep to left center field, and that one is off the scoreboard for a home run, a solo blast for Tayrod, and a 5-0 Cowboys lead. Rodriguez was great on the mound for the Cowboys, going the distance and getting the shutout. Sweet play here by shortstop Audrey Sweet to keep a run from scoring. Livermore gets 4 more in the 6th. The big hit, this Taylor Rapp single up the middle. Scoring is Sweet as the Cowboys win big. Rodriguez a complete game shutout with 11 strikeouts for the victorious Cowboys.
Time for a big-time girls lacrosse matchup. Sacred Heart Prep visiting St. Ignatius. Courtney Tate with the highlights. To the first, score is tied at 3. Phoebe Kim nears the goal and dishes it to the back of the net. SHP takes a 4-3 lead at the half. Jumping to the second, Gator still hot. Iris O'Connor in transition buries it to give SHP a 2-goal lead. The Wildcats fighting back with a chance to tie it up. And Olivia Ripple strikes it home through traffic. We're tied at 6. SHP with an immediate answer. Here's Iris O'Connor again for her second goal of the game. And the Gators are up 1. St. Ignatius firing back. Beautiful pass to Olivia Ripple for the finish. And that's just textbook. We're tied back up at 7. The Gators hoping to regain the lead. Another beautiful pass to Cash Showalter on the move. Nice shot. It's 8-7 SHP. But the Wildcats with some huge final minutes. Olivia Ripple driving through traffic. Olivia with another big time finish. The Denver commit with 7 goals, and her teammates are loving it. 9-8 St. Ignatius. Finally, the Wildcats with a 3-goal lead. Here's Olivia Ripple again from deep. What a shot! And St. Ignatius remains undefeated behind a huge 7-goal performance from Olivia Ripple.
Each week, U.S. Bank brings us stories of athletes who inspire us.
Jake Vanderbrook is here now with the story of a Half Moon Bay basketball player inspired by his sister.
That's right, Robert. When it comes to Dio Lucido, he's a very physical player on the basketball court. And he's doing it for one reason and one reason only. His sister, Michaela. When you look at Half Moon Bay's basketball player, Dio Lucido, you see a very talented sharpshooter. but his decision-making is what stands out the most.
He is one of the most, if not the most, unselfish players out there that we have on the floor. You know, he is not concerned with his shots, how many points he scores, you know, so he's consistently putting the other guys in position for them to score.
For Dio, it's mainly just the sacrifices he makes for this team. A lot of his impact really, it doesn't show up on the stat sheet, but it's really felt in the game.
A game he fell in love with at a very young age, all thanks to his brother Dante.
My dad was like his coach, and he started playing, and he's the oldest sibling, so I just followed him kinda and did what he did.
Dio is one of four siblings in the Lucido family, Dante, Dominic, and his older sister, Michaela. Dio says growing up, he developed a special bond with his older sister.
She was kind of just like always there for me no matter what. If my parents weren't home at work or something, she would like take care of me. It was just like the perfect sibling to ask for.
But the bond no longer exists. On November 20th, 2016, Dio's parents received a knock on the door regarding Michaela's whereabouts.
We got the parents' worst nightmare knock on the door at 1 in the morning that she had hit a tree and died in a car accident.
7 hours later, Dio wakes up and hears the shocking news.
I went outside to the living room and I just see everyone crying and like people I haven't seen in a while. My mom told me and I just like went blank.
She loved him like he was her own child. They're very, very close.
Michaela was just 21 years old. A tragic loss for not only the Lucido family, but for the Half Moon Bay community.
It's just a complete shock. I mean, it's just kind of like, you know, you hear the news and you're like, what? What do you, you know, it just doesn't register.
After we had all, as a family, been out to dinner, she said goodbye to all of us and we took a family picture and she was leaving to go celebrate a friend's birthday. And we had no idea that would be the last time we saw her.
Every second Dio's on the court, he's playing for one person, and it's Michaela.
I feel like I play for her, so that's what makes me like not want to give up or play through hard situations. It definitely like motivates me.
Now as a junior in high school, Dio takes nothing for granted and shows his kindness and appreciation on and off the court.
It's crazy. I tell people all the time he's like my best friend. I think our whole family can't imagine life without him because he brings us together.
Cherish every moment you have, because after something like that happens, you definitely like get scared of situations. Made me realize, you know, the people that you love, you want to like tell them you love them every day. You never know what's going to happen.
Just like the moon, life has its phases. Whether it's good or bad, Dio Lucido strives to persevere and be the best he can be.
Just a terrific young man, a very tough loss, losing his one and only sister at the age of 11. And when I spoke to both Dio and his mom, they were very thankful for the Half Moon Bay community for all the support they received during that difficult time.
He was a great, great young man.
For sure.
Absolutely.
Each week, Wingstop honors Bay Area teachers who do such a great job.
Here's Sam Papp from Palo Alto talking about his favorite teacher, Stacy Kaufman.
My favorite teacher is Miss Kaufman because she does an amazing job of supporting me on and off the field during the classroom, and it's really, really nice to have.
Once again this season, Wingstop will be giving scholarships at the end of the season, honoring Wingstop owner Terry Blanchard. Terry passed away from COVID in April of 2020. Terry did great work in the community. These scholarships keep that effort alive.
Coming up, the Mattress Firm perfect match. It's the other big game in the East Bay League this week as San Ramon Valley hosts De La Salle.
And top softball action as Alameda battles Berkeley right here on 49ers Cal High Sports presented by U.S. Bank.
Okay, so turn left. Take this right. Now pull into that parking space. Now put the car in park.
Great, thanks so much.
It's my lunch break.
You know you want that smoky, tangy, sweet, and spicy sauced and tossed Wingstop where flavor gets its wings.
Join us on the ice for the Bay Area's hottest sport. High school ice hockey leagues are forming now for the upcoming season. Be part of this fast-moving, hard-hitting, crazy exciting game. You can join as part of your high school team or sign up to be assigned to a team. Games are played at Sharks Ice locations all around the Bay Area. Jump in anytime and join your friends on the ice. Be a part of Bay Area High School Hockey. Contact Sharks Ice for more details and get into the game today.
Dreaming while awake?
Junk sleep.
Don't let junk sleep mess with your head.
Welcome to Mattress Firm.
For a limited time at Mattress Firm, get a king for the price of a queen or a queen for a twin. Plus a free adjustable base with qualifying Sealy purchase.
Just go ahead and lift you on up.
You can't put a price on good sleep, but it's better on sale. Mattress Firm. Unjunk your sleep.
One, two, three.
Get ready to cheer for your next new or used car at Stevens Creek Chevrolet.
Stevens Creek Chevrolet!
We're ready to make your buying experience safe and easy. Come to our dealership to see and test drive one of hundreds of great Chevrolet cars and trucks. Or you can go online to shop, order, and have your new car delivered right to your door. So get fired up for a great deal right here at
Stevens Creek Chevrolet!
Sir, hi! Let's get it! Climb it up! Climb it up!
Oh, yeah! 49ers Cal High Sports is brought to you by these fine companies who care about high school sports. By Lexus of Stevens Creek, we get it. By Wingstop, sauced and tossed classic wings, crispy tenders, juicy boneless wings. Order them all at wingstop.com. By DGDG.com, where we want you to be a happy car buyer. And by the Reike Center, where goals and dreams become a reality.
We just saw California and Foothill, the other two teams at the top of the East Bay League, also played this week. De La Salle at 3-0 in league with senior shortstop Alec Nava batting .577 for the Spartans.
The Spartans meeting a San Ramon Valley team with a 5-1 league record. The Wolves batting .327 as a team with a very legit Evan Belinget batting .462. Each week, Mattress Firm wants to find you a mattress that is your perfect match, and each week we scour the section for a perfect match on the field. De La Salle and San Ramon Valley, Friday afternoon.
The San Ramon Valley Raleigh Wolf getting ready to take on De La Salle, and the team was also ready to go. Top one, Michael Banderas getting one of his five Ks in the game. Banderas giving up just two hits. Bottom of the first, the Wolves with a runner on for Jaron Navarez, who turns and sends this one deep to right field. Over the fielder's head, a big blast for Navarez, sending Evan Belinget to third. It's a double for Navarez. Tyler Wood was very impressive for the Spartans, getting the K here to end the threat. Bottom three, now runners at second and third for the Wolves as Jaron Lewis gets that clutch. Hit a rocket down the line and right. Jacob scores. Here comes Donnie Crux scoring. It's a double for Lewis. 2-0 Wolves. Runner at third for the Spartans in the third. The ball hit back at Banderas, who holds the runner at third, then fires to first for the out. A big play there. Still in the third, the pitch is wild. Heading to the plate from third is A.J. Bianchina. It's 2-1. Still in the third, one out for Connor Harrison, who does his job sending it deep enough to the outfield to score Ethan Dungo. We're tied at 2-2 after three. Sixth inning play now, same score. Spartans with a runner at second. The ball is lifted to right. There to make the catch is Evan Belinget, who fires a perfect one-hopper to Blake Jacobs at third to get the out. That is one fantastic throw by Evan Belinget. Bottom six, one out for the Wolves. A grounder hit to short. The Spartans get the out at second, but Danny Crook is safe at first as the go-ahead run comes in to score. That's Chase Salisbury, 3-2 Wolves. Runner on third for De La Salle in the seventh. Fine play here by Colin Linteo at short. He hurt his shoulder on the play. We hope he's okay. His Wolves win 3-2, handing the Spartans their first league loss. A big game for the second baseman, Jaron Lewis.
This means everything. I mean, we took a pretty hard loss on Wednesday. The bats weren't working. I mean, Thursday we just came out and said, man, screw it. Let's just go play. Let's have fun. We weren't having fun on Wednesday. Man, we had fun today. This is a good game.
Adrian Soriano here in Berkeley as the Yellow Jackets take on Alameda. This game was a pitcher's duel throughout. Here's Jasmine Worley getting the backwards K. No score after one. But not to be outdone was Abby Kaneko. Abby gets the call, strike three, as we stay scoreless after two. Berkeley looking to get its offense started in the third. Charlotte Curry-Ohini rips one deep to right. That will roll for a while as Charlotte makes it to third for a triple. Melody Castro up to bat next, and Melody hits one to right. Here comes Charlotte, and she is safe at the plate, and it's 1-0 Berkeley after three. The Hornets trying to answer back in the fourth, but Kaneko throws to Czar Fleischman for one. Then Czar fires to Castro at third for the 1-3-5 double play. Still 1-0 Yellow Jackets after four. Alameda finally gets on the board in the sixth. Ashley Nakano lines one to right for a base hit. Emily Yee comes in to score, and it's all tied up at one after six. Berkeley with the winning run on base in the seventh, but Horley gets the punch out to end the inning and send the game into extras. The Yellow Jackets with runners at first and second in the ninth, but Horley once again comes through with a big strikeout to send the game into the 10th inning. The ghost runner rule now in effect in the 10th, and Fleischman grounds one down the third baseline. It's a fair ball. Here comes Elise Hyten, and she is safe at the plate as Berkeley walks it off in the 10th and improved to 4-0 in the West Alameda County Foothill League.
Lexus of Stevens Creek brings us the Volunteer Award each week, celebrating young people who donate their time to do good work in their communities.
We are now in the voting phase for the Volunteer Award Scholarship. Click on the QR code on the screen, which takes you to the Lexus of Stevens Creek Facebook page, and vote for your favorite volunteer.
This season, Gallo Salami will help us find top recruits and find out where they stand in the recruiting process.
This week's Gallo Salami Big Salami is Javon Johnson from De La Salle, the 6'4 senior guard committing this week to play next season at Cal State Monterey. Coming up, night baseball as Alameda goes against Bishop O'Dowd.
And Silver Creek at Santa Teresa softball. This is 49ers Cal High Sports presented by U.S. Bank.
Welcome back to our NBC Sports studios. The top two teams in the West Alameda County Foothill League met this week. Bishop O'Dowd with some construction on campus, so their home games are played at Laney College. The Dragons enjoying the power hitting of senior A.J. Carter, who is batting 371.
Alameda behind legendary head coach Ken Arnrich and Cal Poly commit Jay Cross coming into the game tied with O'Dowd at 2-0 in league. The Hornets and Dragons meeting on Wednesday night.
Adrian Soriano here at Laney College as Alameda takes on Bishop O'Dowd. This one was a pitcher's duel early. Caden Wooster getting the batter to chase for strike three. No score after one. But not to be outdone was junior Miles Taylor. Miles getting one of his five punch-outs on the game. Still no score after two. The Dragons break through in the third. Tyler Barcy grounds one through the infield for a base hit. Cole Jones comes in to score, and it's 1-0 Bishop O'Dowd. Then a couple batters later, A.J. Carter rips one deep to center field, just shy of the fence for a triple. Barcy and Siraj Sabat scores, 3-0 Dragons. One more for Bishop O'Dowd as the throw gets away. A.J. Carter comes in to score, and it's 4-0 Dragons after three. Alameda looking to answer back in the fourth, but Ben Scouse throws a strike to Barcy at second to nab the runner, still 4-0 O'Dowd after four. The Hornets trying to get into the hit column in the fifth, but Wooster gets the backwards K here as Caden keeps the no-hitter intact through five innings. Justin Iglesias would come into pitch in the sixth, and Justin gets the batter looking for strike three, and the no-hitter is still intact after six. Alameda looking to rally late, but Jacob Antone gobbles up the grounder and fires to Cole Pugsley for the final out as both Iglesias and Wooster combine for the no-hitter. Bishop O'Dowd improves to 3-0 in the West Alameda Foothill League.
Ivan Garcia here in San Jose as the Santa Teresa Saints host league rival Silver Creek Raiders. Top of the first, runner on second, Kalia Eco with a perfect bunt over the third baseman and beats the throw. Good hustle there. Next batter, Andrea Alvarez hits it deep to right, and it's just far enough to bring home Amiya Noriega. Raiders strike first, 1-0. Bottom first, runner on first, Kokoro Sage hits a line drive to right, and now it's runners on first and second. Paris Uribe at the plate, and Uribe finds a gap into center field. Bases clear and double. Gianna Martinico and Sage brought home, and it's 2-1 Saints. Jump to the top of the fifth. Two outs, runner on first, Noriega steals second. A wild throw, goes to center field, and Noriega dives and steals third. Full count, Maria Avalos throws a strike to get out of the inning, one of her eight strikeouts on the day. Bottom six, two outs, Saga hits towards third, and it goes off the third baseman's glove and is safe at first. Isabella Gianbruno up next and lays a bunt to advance pitch runner Cassandra Soria to second. Uribe up to bat and hits a grounder to left, and Soria rounds third, tag on another RBI for Uribe. Down to the last out for the Raiders. Soria fields it, throws it first, and ends the game. Smiles all around for the Saints as Santa Teresa beats Silver Creek 3-1 after a three RBI game from Uribe.
Each week, the Harker School helps us honor top scholar athletes. This week's scholar athlete is Evan Kleinhans from Albany Baseball. Evan, great on the field and in the classroom with a 4.3 GPA.
Brought to you by the Harker School, the Harker Conservatory last week produced this year's upper school spring musical, The Drowsy Chaperone, a hilarious and affectionate parody of 1920s musical theater featuring elaborate dance numbers, outrageous characters, and jazz age-inspired comedy. At Harker, transitional kindergarten through 12th grade students discover their passions. Learn more at harker.org. Remember, if you weren't able to be at the game, we have entire game videos available for purchase. Click on the QR code on the screen for the list of available games. Order the game, we'll send you a download, and you have it forever.
Be sure to check us out on social media for lots of fun content, including videos, news updates, and a whole lot more. We are at 49ers Cal High everywhere, and you can subscribe to our YouTube channel to get updates on when new videos are posted each week.
Coming up, our CCS SunPower electric game. It's the league-leading Lancers from St. Francis battling Mitty.
And terrific lacrosse action with Miramonte and Ocalanes. 49ers Cal High Sports presented by U.S. Bank will be right back.
If we build this, all the players and fans will magically appear. I call it the Field of Fame. Of course, I'll have to tear down the garage, fill in the pool, and lose the trees. So can I get a loan?
So as your friend, I love it. But
as your banker, not so much.
Let me talk to the friend.
You could always invest in a college fund.
No, my kids aren't going to college. They're going to work at the stadium.
Our kids are going to college.
Football's back, and so are the fans.
My wife wants to build a college.
For more than 65 years, Cupertino Electric has been delivering power and possibilities. With offices throughout California and project sites throughout the U.S., Cupertino Electric today builds renewable, commercial, utility, and data center projects for some of the most influential companies in the world. Beyond that, we are a people company. We build family, communities, and meaningful careers. Visit CEI.com today or connect with us on LinkedIn, Facebook, or other social sites to see our openings and join our team.
My name's Gary Rikus, and I'm the Executive Director and founder of the Rikus Center for Human Enhancement. Anyone can come regardless of their ability to pay and perform, and anyone is as important as anyone could possibly be. The staff here are the thing. So it's not me, and it's not the facility. The staff is what implements those values and helps the people make progress. So as a service organization that's trying to help someone accomplish their goals, I couldn't be prouder of what we're doing.
At Levi's Stadium with the SunPower electric game, the St. Francis Lancers started this week undefeated and all alone in first place in the West Catholic League.
The Mitty Monarchs were two games back and needing a win over the first place Lancers to get back in the league title hunt. The game is our CCS SunPower electric game, and our Adrian Soriano was there.
Electric game.
This game features two of the top pitchers in the WCAL. For Mitty, it's sophomore Luca Pintar. Luca is 4-0 on the season with a 2.33 ERA and 24 strikeouts. For St. Francis, it's junior Jack Surdy. Jack has only allowed one earned run so far this season with 24 strikeouts. Can the Monarchs topple the undefeated St. Francis Lancers, or will the Lancers go 7-0 in league play? Let's find out in our CCS SunPower electric game. St. Francis gets on the board first. Elias Duncan sends one deep to left field. That ball is gone. A leadoff solo blast for Elias. 1-0 Lancers. Then with runners in scoring position, Tristan Kim grounds one up the middle for a base hit. Wyatt King scores, and it's 2-0 St. Francis. Derek Gilley up to bat next, and Derek hits it through the infield for a single. Christian Galvez scores. Right behind them is Max Ross. 4-0 St. Francis. Elias at the plate again in the second, and Duncan hits it to left center. Oh my goodness, somebody get this man some Dunkin' Donuts. Elias's second solo blast of the game, and it's 5-0 Lancers. Wyatt King up to bat next, and Wyatt sends one to left. Bring out the tape measure. That one is off the roof. back-to-back solo shots for the Lancers, 6-0. The Lancers tack on another run as Max Ross hits it to center for a base hit. Ryan Lee scores and it's 7-0 St. Francis after two. More Lancers in the third. Brady Choi smokes one to right center. Jilly comes in to score. The Lancers get another on an error and it's 9-0 St. Francis after three. Mitty gets one back in the fourth as Ben Kim draws the bases loaded walk. That allows Mateo Blandino to come in and score. It's 9-1 Lancers after four. But the Lancers answer back in the fifth. Brady Choi launches one to deep left field, just shy of the fence. Racing around third and scoring is Danny Moscoro. 12-1 Lancers after five. Mitty still fighting till the end. Michael Forney rips it to deep left field. Adios, pelota! A three-run bomb for Michael, but not enough as St. Francis wins it 15-6 to go to 7-0 in the West Catholic League. Here's Elias Duncan after the game.
We just need to stay consistent with the bats. It's the best offensive game we've had all year. We just got to stay consistent. That's the main thing, main key.
In San Jose with the CCS SunPower Electric game, I'm Adrian Soriano, 49ers Cal High Sports.
Ivan Garcia here in Lafayette as the Acalanes Dons host league rival Miramonte Matadors. Kevin Chang scored the first two goals for the Matadors early into the game as Miramonte leads 2-0. The Dons would answer back in the same way. Two straight goals, Owen Esty slings one into the net for the score. The Matadors tag on one more as the first ends Miramonte 3-2. Into the second, both teams add a goal. Matadors on the attack, the shot is blocked, it's in the air, and Matthew Hawkins high points the ball, turns and scores, making it 5-3. Mid-second, the Dons looking to keep the game close. Zach Appel with a nice jump shot as Miramonte still leads 7-5 at the end of three. Early second, Antrel Smith lines up a shot and scores as the Matadors take a three-point lead. Late third, Cooper Olsen makes a bounce shot into the back of the net, but the Matadors still hold that three-point lead going into the fourth. And the Matadors will start to pull away early. Three unanswered goals, including this goal from Chris Morrison, puts the Matadors up by six. The Dons will try to come back into the game, but Chang will deny any comeback after scoring his sixth goal of the night. The Matadors move on to 6-0 in the Diablo Athletic League after a monster performance from Chang.
Coming up, Bay Valley League action as Pittsburgh travels to Liberty.
But first, here's our Cupertino Electric Power Rankings for softball.
Back at the NBC Sports Studio here at Levi's Stadium, the Pittsburgh Pirates starting Bay Valley League play this week after a very successful pre-league season.
Liberty picking up two league wins last week and looking to keep the momentum going against Pittsburgh on Thursday.
The coaches and umpires go over the ground rules as Pittsburgh takes on Liberty. Jake Vanderbrook with the highlights. Some high drama in the first. Pitt gets a stolen base as the throw goes into the outfield. Haylen Guerrero is on the loose. The junior rounds third. The throw home is in time as Christian Lorcher slaps the tag to record the out. My goodness. But the Pirates regroup in the third as Victor Valle drops a beautiful bunt towards third, leading to a single. Next batter, Guerrero smacks this ball to left field for a base knock. Valle rounds third and is heading home, and this time the throw is not in time. Pirates take a 1-0 lead, but Liberty loads the bases in the bottom half. James Stonebarger records the easiest RBI in baseball as he draws a walk to score Jake Hyland, all tied at one. Next batter, Evan Matienzo hits a grounder the second. The ball gets away from the second baseman. Lorcher scores. Michael Baker coming in hot. He scores. And Liberty takes a 3-1 lead. Still in the third. James Stonebarger gets a good jump off a wild pitch and slides headfirst to extend the Lions' lead to three. But David Roberts had a phenomenal outing on the bump. Here in the sixth, he gets the batter looking on the outside corner for the strikeout. And in the seventh, Roberts just keeps dealing. How about another strikeout to close out the ball game? A complete game for David Roberts as the sophomore records the win on the bump, finishing with 9 strikeouts and allowing just 1 run on 3 hits.
We'll head to San Jose for some volleyball action. Harker on the road visiting Lynbrook. Courtney Tate with the highlights. First set, Lynbrook with a 1-point lead. Alex Lee sends it up to Nin Lee, and Nin crushes it to the hardwood. The Vikings up 6-4 early. Later, the Eagles start to pull away. Harker sends it over, but it's blocked by Kyle Wyatt, one of his 7 blocks of the game. Lynbrook takes the first set 25-15 to the second. Harker with the chance to tie it up, and Edith Masick sends it over to score the point. Score is tied at 7. Lynbrook pulls pulling away later in the second. Ben Ching takes the shot. Ben scores the point, and the Vikings take set 2, 25-17. Set 3, Lindbrook with the 3-point lead. Adrian Liu up to Edis Masek, and Edis slams it home to cut the lead to 2. Harker still fighting. The Vikings send it over, but Kyle Johnson comes up with a big-time block, and the Eagles take set 3, 25-23. To the 4th, Lindbrook trying to keep it close. Kyle with a beautiful shot to the hardwood to cut the lead to 1 later. Harker trying to send it to 5. Johnny Kunis up to Vishnu Kanon. Vishnu with the monster slam. What a comeback to the 5th. Lindbrook trying to take a late lead, and Kyle Wyatt hammers it home to score, and that'll do it. Lindbrook hangs on, and Ben Ching led the way with 14 kills and 4 aces.
Each week this season, Merriwest Credit Union brings us athletes giving credit to those people who have made their success happen.
Here's Miles Liu from Lee High School giving credit to his travel ball coach.
The person that I give credit to is Mark Obenauer, or I call him Obi, as everyone does. He's helped me shape the person that I am today, not only on the field, but off the field as well. And, you know, I wouldn't be where I am without him.
DGDG.com wants you to be a happy car buyer, so each week we show you the Be Happy Play.
This week's Be Happy Play goes to
Zar Fleischman from Berkeley High School with a single down the left field line. In to score is Elise Houghton, and that is the winning run right there, and they were very happy about it. Go to DGDG.com to see how you can be a happy car buyer.
Coming up, it's the Service by Medallion Play of the Week. I think it's going to be this play. You're going to have to wait to find out.
But first, here is this week's training tip from our good friends at the Rikus Center.
Everyone, I'm Coach Justin. For today's training tip of the week, we're going to go with a med ball slam. Natalie here is going to bring the ball straight above her head. She's going to get onto her tippy toes and drop the ball straight down. She's trying to break the floor. To progress it, she's going to actually get into a split stance. So she's going to get into a split stance, and she's going to let the leg fly. All right. It's a good exercise to develop full body power.
Service by Medallion brings us the Play of the Week award. All the winners vying for the Play of the Year and the coveted championship belt.
We'll show you some contenders and then name this week's Play of the Week.
Of the week.
We started Berkeley with Abby Kaneko firing to Zar Fleischman at first for 1. Then Zar fires to Melody Castro to get the runner at third for a 1-3-5 double play. Here's Julia Runyon from St. Mary's with a diving dive at the plate to get the runner. Here's Ricky Vidal from Santa Teresa making the play from his knees to get the runner at second. But the play of the week goes to San Ramon Valley's Evan Belinget. Evan makes the catch, then fires a one-hopper to third for the second out. It's a 9-5 double play. Let's see it in slow-mo. What a fantastic throw from Evan. Sir, you just won the play of the week.
That's the play of the week, and that's 49ers Cal High Sports for this week. Thanks for watching. I'm Robert Bronstein.
And I'm Aubrey Tolliver. Stay right there for 49ers Sac High Sports. We'll have highlights from the big Elk Grove Franklin game. Don't go anywhere.